today. That of the renewal of the vows of Benjamin, Jeremiah, and Shadrick and Natasha Ross for their renewal of their vows, of their rings. And we are excited to express our joy, our love for God by your mere presence and your mere participation. And what is a wonderful, wonderful occasion. And I would like to say that most everyone in this room, do you mind? I think I'm about 6 feet away from everyone. Am I okay? If I offend, let me know. I'll put it right back on.
You're good.
But I will let you know this, that we are here in the presence of Almighty God. So everything we say and everything we do, it has purpose. It has a very important statement that we're making to their hearts as we engage them. So we're going to change the music just a little bit. And Benjamin Jeremiah, Ben, will you please come forward? Because I want you to be standing here in this part of the service. Thank you. Because we are going to play some music that is reminiscent of the spouse who is the one being received. And most of the services I've been to in the past, it was such a momentous event that those who were participating and those who were present actually stood up.
That's
so to recognize the completion. So this is just one part, but the completion of the union. So let us begin with the music and then the presentation of Shadrick. So when the music starts, I wouldn't want you to stand too early. I love that saying both of those names. So, I grew up with my mother saying both of our names, but we knew that it was something special going on, and we better get right there real soon, because when she said both names, like, Benjamin Jeremiah? Oh, my goodness. You better come. So we thank the Lord for you. And I'm going to get back here. And we
watch out.
Yeah. Okay. Going this way?
Yeah. Don't go anywhere.
Don't go any further. Which way do I go to get behind there? Okay. Let's have a word of prayer, please. God, you're the centerpiece of our life. You're the centerpiece of our faith. You're the centerpiece of our love, our existence. Lord, how we wake up this morning, we wake up in your mercy. How we go through the day is by the strength you've given us. And how we receive those things that are from you, God, it's by thanks. It is by worship. It is by praise that we give you the glory. You are the one, oh God, that is the most in our life. And here we are today, oh Lord, to recognize this renewal. What, Lord, wisdom and energy and faith you've given these two, oh God, to import in their lives that you are the centerpiece of love, oh God, in their life. And we give you the glory, honor, and the praises. We take an effort, Lord, to take their wishes and make it a reality that we renew the vows and the rings and the commitment and the focus unto you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. How many are excited just as much as I am?
Amen.
Isn't it all right?
It's all right.
How God does it. It's all right when he moves. It's all right when he has his way that he expresses himself unto us. Now, let me just take a moment to fulfill one of the first requests that this couple has shared to me. And that is, it's a simple thing, and probably to everyone in this room, I would venture to say that you already have done this. But God is a gracious God. He's the creator of the universe. He is the one who made the difference between darkness and light. He made a difference between everything created to the point that he rested on the seventh day. He created man on the sixth day and had a wonderful wedding ceremony that he presented the wife to the bride, to the groom, and it was a wonderful, wonderful marriage. Everybody knows Genesis chapters 1 and 2.
Yes.
Life began on 3 though, didn't it? It really became robust. And we know the importance of making the vows be where they are as God intended, unto him and that eternal.
Yeah.
So in order to have that perspective, they wanted me to just bring a very short message on the good news. The good news is that God has only a plan A. And that plan A is for us to be with him forever. That plan A included that his son, who was right there with the Godhead, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, in eternity past, in the foundation of the world, he made it such that Christ Jesus was going to come into the world and be the propitiation, to be the one who does the reconciliation of the breach that has taken place because of this one thing called sin. And it's so important that Christ came, that he is the one by which we come to God the Father. It's through the Son. And it's because of the Son, we, and the price he paid all the way to the cross, being quickened alive by the Holy Spirit on the third day, he became the way to have fellowship with God, with an emboldened faith, faith enough to ask the Lord to forgive us of our sin, faith enough to ask God to cleanse us, faith enough to ask the Lord to break those things which held us back and held us down and had us separated from him. It was then when we were separated from him that he sent Christ to bring us back. So the whole matter is that whatever state of being in this world that we're in, we ask Christ Jesus our Lord to forgive us of our sins. to come and live in us, and we live in him. Amen. So if you haven't done that, if you haven't come to realize that true love starts with that relationship with God.
That's right.
I'm telling you, we have a golden opportunity to get to know him and to make him known. Because after you get to know him, it's just something about faith in God that you have to let somebody know God. It's just in you. Jeremiah put it simply, it's like it's fire. Like fire shut up in my bones. Oh my goodness. And so with all of that, I'm asking, is there anyone who may not have experienced what I've experienced, or what Ben has experienced, or what Shadrika has experienced in the forgiveness of our sins through Christ Jesus our Lord? And he is Lord. Whether you recognize it or not. Because he said in his word, every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. And I don't want a rock in this earth to be my lips. I don't want a stubborn heart to be my lips. I don't want a blind heart to be my lips. I want to confess it because I am willingly wanting to let the world know he saved me. He brought me out of junk and mess, put me on solid ground, and gave me his best. So with that, I'm trying to tell you, if you can't express that in a few words, you haven't received what God has that's best for you, called his through his grace, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. So I think this is a good way that they wanted this wedding vow renewal to take place. I'd like everybody to receive what I've received. That's just what you're saying. And so with that, is there anyone who would like to receive Christ in their life? Okay. We are ready to go. Give God a hand, praise.
All right.
Hallelujah. Thank you. Hallelujah to his name. So, with that being said, see, on January 19th, 2019, they were already married. They got married on that day. And so here we are today, on February 26th, 2022, renewing our vows. Oh, what a heart for God. What a wonderful heart for God. So we're going to go forward with that, and I am going to put on my help me's and just graciously go forward where we don't get it wrong, we get it right. Here I want to scroll down to a meaningful passage. It's 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 through 8. Do I have a reader in the room? AJ?
Yes.
Would you go to 1 Corinthians and read 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 through 8? And little Jackson Xavier, what is one of the most important words in that chapter? What one word comes to mind? What did you say, Jackson Xavier? Can you say it a little louder where everybody gets it?
Love.
That word love. Now, that word love comes with a meaning and understanding. Agape love.
That's right.
Agape love.
That's
God's love. God is love. And he is the one who is the centerpiece of their love relationship.
Oh, yeah.
The
we come and read it?
Please.
Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not envy. It is not boast. It is not proud. It is not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angry. It keeps no recording of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. It always protects. It always trusts. It always hopes. It always perseveres. Love never fails.
And that's good enough. That's verse 8, right? That's the start of it, right? That's the start of verse 8. Love never fails.
Right.
Oh my goodness. That's what this ceremony is all about, to build up their faith in the godly love, that love that God has that never fails. Mm-hmm. So here we are. Benjamin and Shadrika. I am getting ready to do a call and response with you. I'm going to say some words. That's the call. And I'm going to ask that you respond with the word I do. If that is your position, to say I do. Under the eyes of God, I solemnly bear witness to the marriage ceremonial proceedings. I will now finalize the sacred ceremony you shall both enter into on this day. The rule of marriage is an ancient institution and an important AJ?
Yes.
Come up here. Benjamin and Shadrika, I invite you to express your sacred vows to one another. sorry. Sadrika, please join hands under the eyes of God. Benjamin, do you take Sadrika to be your lawfully wedded spouse?
I do.
Do you promise to support them completely and love them unconditionally, so as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Under the eyes of God, Sadrika, do you take Benjamin to be your lawfully wedded spouse? Do you promise to support him completely and love him unconditionally?
I do.
So long as you both shall live?
I do.
Very well, let us proceed.
Now,
now it's going to be the ring exchange. It is now time to exchange the ring. May these rings remind you always of these sacred policies, promises you've made to each other. Today, in the company of your family and friends,
after me. I, Benjamin,
give you, Shadrika,
this ring,
as a symbol,
of, oh, I'm sorry, of my love.
Of my love.
Committed.
Committed.
And eternal.
And eternal.
Vow.
Vows.
We have made. Today to each other.
Today to each other.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Shadrika.
Shadrika.
It's your turn. I, Shadrika.
Give you, Benjamin,
this ring as the symbol of my love. Committed and eternal are my vows we made to each other today. And with this ring, I be with. By the power invested in me, by the state of Washington, and by my ordained reverend license, I pronounce you, Benjamin and Shadrika, husband and wife, under the lawful wedding before God. You may kiss the bride. Now, will you face the audience, please? I present to everybody in this room Benjamin Jeremiah Shadrika Natasha Ross. Woo.
Son has asked me to do his wedding, which I would not be hesitant in doing that. Okay, this good. He's got
it. Can you lift the camera?
Ben. Ask him.
B. Can we do that afterwards, sir?
Thank you.
Where's the paper?
It'll just be a moment. So you guys just stand there and look beautiful for the camera. All right.
It's in Mother Reed's car.
Oh.
Oh, no.
Yes.
All right. I got it.
I'm just picking it up.
What are we doing now?
It's the marriage certificate.
In the interim.
Here, I'll go get it. Where's the card?
Mother Reed?
Yes.
Will you go with my son, Tim? And he'll probably, and once you get close to point at your vehicle, he'll probably go the rest of the way and you can tell him where it is and all of that. Now, if anyone would, thank you. If anyone would like to, I'd like to just, for my sake, acknowledge those. That we're such a small party that I would really like to hear your names and tell us who you are.